Greetings in the name of the Lord. This is TR Post. I'm here with my friend Marty. We are recording this video in Charleston, South Carolina. I've been doing street evangelism now for a little over 3 weeks here, and Marty has joined me in some of my outings. And we've seen many people come to know the Lord. And today we decided to add a new technique to our soul-winning repertoire. Now, those of you that know me for a while will probably recall that usually when I approach people with the gospel, I do something called a survey technique. By asking people short, direct questions, you can maintain control of the conversation and find out quickly what a person's spiritual beliefs are. Well, today we decided to add something new, which we tried on a few people. Not too long ago, I read a book by Kevin Dedmon called The Ultimate Treasure Hunt. And what Kevin does is before he goes out on the streets, he waits before the Lord and he asks the Lord for clues regarding certain people that he'll be approaching later on as he goes out hitting the streets. And among the clues that Kevin asks the Lord for is location, such as a stop sign, a coffee shop, a Walmart or Target, a person's name, a person's appearance, such as a particular piece of clothing they're wearing or the color of their hair, what they might need prayer for, maybe a particular part of the body that they need healing for, and the unusual. You know, God may give you some unusual clues like a lollipop, a windmill, dolphins. It could be just about anything. We can't put God in a box, and God will sometimes use, he'll give us unusual clues to reach people. And the purpose for the treasure hunt is to reach people that may not respond to other types of evangelism. And right away we saw this work. The first person I led to the Lord was a guy in a liquor store. What happened was, as soon as we left the church here, we were walking up King Street, and we were about to walk past this liquor store, and one of the clues that I had was a red hat. And Marty noticed there was a woman sitting inside this liquor store with a red hat. And so I perceived that I was supposed to talk to this woman. Her name was Doreen. She already knew the Lord, but then I asked her if she needed prayer for anything. And she mentioned she needed finances and a job, which was another clue that was on my treasure hunt sheet. So I prayed in agreement with her that God would bless her with a good job that would provide her more than the finances she needed. Then I started leaving the liquor store, but I felt in my spirit I wasn't ready to leave yet. So I thought, well, maybe I'm supposed to talk to the man behind the counter. I handed him a tract. I was about to walk away, but since the Lord said, no, go back and talk to him. So I ministered to this man. He wasn't sure if he was going to spend eternity in heaven, but he claimed to be a churchgoer. So I shared the gospel with him. His name was Val, and Val prayed to receive salvation right there in the liquor store. So that was the first of 21 people we got to lead to the Lord today. Actually, originally I had set a goal for 10 salvations, and God gave us more than double the goal. Marty also had some clues on his treasure hunt for him. You want to share a couple of those?
Two of the things that I got was a person sitting on a park bench and a girl around, either in college or around that age, or that looked like she was in college, wearing a blue shirt. Now, this girl happened to be wearing blue shorts, but we talked to her and she accepted Christ. And another guy was actually met three descriptions. There was a guy sitting on a park bench. Another description that I got was a guy in an army green shirt, and he was wearing an army green shirt, and also the name Michael, and his name happened to be Michael, and we prayed for him, and he said he already knew the Lord, but we prayed for him anyways. He had a need for finances. So.
I also prayed with someone named Michael. There was a young man and two young woman, they were walking up the street. I felt led to approach them, and none of them knew for sure if they were going to spend eternity in heaven, so I shared the gospel with them. They all prayed to receive salvation, and at the end, Michael just started laughing hysterically. I mean, the joy of the Lord was hitting this guy. And then not too long afterwards, I felt led to approach this woman. She had a neck brace on, and she also was, she had a crutch. She was using a crutch to help her walk. And one of the clues that I got was armpit. And God confirmed that I was supposed to talk to this woman. She was already saved. But then I felt I'd ask if she wanted me, if she would like to receive healing. So I prayed with her to receive healing. And right afterwards, she started moving her right arm, which she could not do before. So I believe that was why God gave me the clue armpit. Because she was using that crutch to help her walk.
Another thing that I saw was a silver bicycle with black and red on it. And that was actually the last person that we talked to today. We saw a guy sitting on some steps, and right in front of him was a silver bicycle with red and black paint on it.
Now, some of you may not have evangelized before. Maybe you're scared to evangelize. Well, the Bible says that God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power, love, and a sound mind. The hardest part about evangelizing is simply getting started. So I'll just encourage you, step out. I mean, Marty didn't start evangelizing until about a couple weeks ago. We started going out together, and I've seen some progress with him. He's approaching people now where he hadn't before. I've seen him pray with people to receive salvation. So if God can use us, he can certainly use you. God's not looking for ability. He's looking for availability. And once again, if you want some helpful tools on how to evangelize, I encourage you to go to my website, signsandwonders.org. I've written my own evangelism track. You can download a copy of this for free. Just go to my website store. And if you want to try using the treasure hunt form yourself, again, just look for it on the internet. Or better yet, buy the book that Kevin Dedmon wrote on the ultimate treasure hunt. There's a lot of interesting testimonials that he wrote. But however you choose to approach people with the gospel and presenting the gospel, just make yourself available to the Lord. Just like God told Moses in Exodus 4:12, go, I'll be with your mouth and teach you what you shall say.
I just want to say for the people who feel like this approach won't work with them, that I had a few hesitations today when I went out with Todd. That one was that I have trouble sometimes discerning the difference between what is the voice of God and what's my own thoughts. But I prayed and I trusted God that he would give me some guidance, and he did. And another thing was that I felt like I wouldn't really feel comfortable with this approach, but it worked. And once you actually get out there and get doing it, it gets easier.
And whether you see one person come to the Lord or 100, our job is to simply share the gospel and leave the results up to the Lord. So thank you for watching this video, and until next time, be blessed and highly favored of the Lord.